Actually, health matters is a special topic because it's a high vulnerability in the public health sector. As a result, that's what we were talking before. We have to make our referrals to the National Center of the Healthcare. So you acquire a big burden that you have to deal with, you and the parents and the whole medical team. So we go on to gather all together, so how we can evaluate the physical and the psychological boundaries so as to give us useful guidelines for the creation of perinatal care centers. Because as Mrs. Agrogiannis said, better perinatal cares, and as we make the better foundation, the better the optimum cost. So we'll go on. So our purpose together today is to highlight the need for acknowledging the importance and impact of both physical and emotional closeness between preterm infant and the parent in the neonatal intensive care unit. Because the impact of premature birth is primarily into the mother. By the premature birth, the mother is unexpectedly and therefore unpreparedly separated from the infant. This lack of preparedness of the premature birth disturbs the transition to parenting as one of the most dynamic family life cycles. So the parenthood has started like in a bad dream. The maternal representation of the preterm mother. Due to the unexpected preterm labor, the mothers of the premature born infants are themselves premature mothers. So the pregnancy is not completed and the mother feels her pregnancy as unfinished. She is not pregnant anymore, but does not feel like a mother either. She carries the child neither in her belly, but neither nor in her hands. At approximately 7 months of pregnancy, the mother has a fairly well-defined image of her infant. Usually, that a vigorous, active, and gratifying 3-month-old, not a full-term neonate. The premature mother expects for the bodily separation. The mother and the child are also specially separated by an inevitable transfer of the premature infant to a neonatal intensive care unit. So we have these wonderful ladies to accept these neonates. The feeling of uselessness is reinforced by this physical separation from her infant, who is placed in a neonatal intensive care unit. Unfortunately, with any early birth, she finds herself facing neither a gratifying month-old nor even a solid and well-developed full-term infant. Instead, she encounters an infant who is frail, not very pretty, fragile, hyper-dependent, and easily overwhelmed. She is a premature and disappointed mother. Even more, this unfinished and vulnerable infant makes her feel like a mother who has not been able to fulfill her pregnancy and become a real mother. She has a sense of being inferior, not being good enough, being less competent since she was not able to carry the baby to full term. She blames herself, reaches for reasons so she could have caused the premature labor, feel guilty instead of the expected solid valorizations through the mother role. She feels it rather as devaluation of her person. She fears for the reaction of the family, friends, acquaintances and colleagues, which are in fact often hurtful. She is a mother who is premature, disappointed, and isolated. She experiences herself as vulnerable and have failed. On top of that, she has the parents, and the mother especially, and the couple of the parents have to negotiate the parental role in the NICU. How that happens? The parents of premature born infants cannot realize their protective and supportive role, hence it is an additional obstacle. The accommodation, the nourishment, and the treatment of the child, as well as decision making, are only one part under their influence and responsibility. They have to accept the medical and nursing personnel, that takes over those roles as well as the neonatal intensive care unit. Isolation between parents and infants often attributed to the complex technological support crucial for the infant's viability can place immense strain on parents, leading to parents feeling less confident and more alienated from their infants and incompetent in the parental role. Poor and restricted self-parent interaction and communication can exasperate parents' sense of isolation from their parent infants. It has also been suggested that parents' negative emotion and experiences associated with prematurity or infant illness have led them to withdraw physically and emotionally, thereby handing over the care of their infants and staff. How feels the separated newborn? What are the experiences of the separated newborn? The physical presence of the mother, but also regulatory support for the mother's intuitive competence as needed for an optimal mother-infant interaction, which is the optimal infant development. The fetus, which was a few hours ago, due to the premature birth, separated from its natural optimal environment, optimal natural environmental influences and experiences unsuddenly situated and forced to live in the intensive care unit, the well-known NICU. Animal studies also have shown that prolonged or repeated physical separation between parents and newborn alters brain development, impairs the ongoing bonding and attachment process, and has long-lasting effects on, for example, emotional programming. The maternal experiences of premature birth. The parental response to premature mediates the risk for later adverse outcomes such as sleeping and feeding problems related to prematurity. The intensity of the post-traumatic stress reaction of the parents is an important predictor for those problems. The maternal traumatic experience related to premature birth has potentially long-lasting influence on the mother-infant interactions. Since mothers of high-risk infants, as well as mothers, have experienced traumatic stress, and the perinatal period shows less sensitivity and more controlling during at 6 months of infant age, whereby the interactions behavior of the preterm infants correlates with maternal traumatic stress. And what about physical and parental closeness? The physical closeness refers to being specially closed, an emotional closeness to parental feeling of being emotionally connected to the infant, experiences feeling of love, warmth, and affection. Parental closeness can be lead to improved child outcomes by many mechanisms. One mechanism may be the improved sleep, which has been associated with skin-to-skin contact in preterm infants. Mrs. Gadjeva showed you, second, parents' participation in pain management. Pain management is also a huge topic that may be reduced in preterm infants and moderate the use of pain medication with the presence of parents. Attachment and bonding in the NICU. Such separation due to premature birth can affect parent-infant attachment development. Here I've put this well-known book of Dr. Klaus, the Klauses actually, Klaus and Kennel. Many editions is probably the most well-known book of perinatology and neonatology, along with studies of bonding and attachment. So such separation due to the premature birth can affect parent-infant attachment development. Even standard maternity work practices, such as isolation of the newborn, separation of mother and infant immediately after birth, and the division of the family unit, which happens at the very time when it is symbolically and in reality becoming an actual family, have been called now into question. When several studies filming mother-child first contact show differences in maternal attachment behavior. How is related separation and parental depression? It is possible that separation from the infant as one mechanism that increases the risk of perinatal depression. Early physical separation from the infant with 24 hours of birth is related to an increase in parents' NICU-related stress. Furthermore, prolonged physical separation between mothers and infants is also known to cause maternal stress, anxiety, and depression. Emerging evidences suggest that care practices supporting physical and emotional closeness between the parent preterm infant decrease the prevalence of maternal depression, similar to level reported in mothers of full-term infants. Furthermore, psychological well-being of the parents of preterm infants have a long-term impact in terms of later child behavior. So, we have already mentioned the centered, family-centered approach. Because how we approach the preterm infant, we have to approach the family. That the sighting in the first hours of life may contribute to reduce abandonment was expectedly observed in several countries. After UNICEF initiated in the 90s, a 10-point program called the Baby Friendly Initiative. When a mother is permitted to have early contact, an opportunity for suckling during the first hour and roaming in with her infant, she will breastfeed more successfully and for longer periods of time. Shortly after birth, there is a sensitive period which appears to have long-lasting effects on maternal attachment and which may ultimately affect the development of the child. Therefore, by all interventions that include the separation of mother and child, one has to think about the possible interference and impairments from both the child's and the mother's side. What do we know about kangaroo care? We have an excellent paradigm shown with a grown-up baby, grown-up preterm by Mrs. Gadjeva. But the initiation of kangaroo care was that in Colombia. It was introduced by Edgar A. Sanabria in 1971 in a children's clinic in Bogota that was overcrowded, so the premature born infants, but unable to offer them neither intensive care, treatment, nor take adequate care of all of them. So mothers were advised to take their babies home and carry them on breast for days or weeks. Through the intervention, babies supplied with warmth and fed with milk. So imported from Colombia, actually adapted for NICU application and incorporated in the NICU setting. The kangaroo care became one of the most important care standards in the developed countries nowadays. So what can health professionals offer? Healthcare professionals could help a premature mother a great deal by recognizing her vulnerability and helping her to connect with her infant. Early clinical management and emotional care for mothers and infants based on the principles of birth is an opportunity for recognition and change, meeting the mother, the real and the imagined infant, appreciation of the infant's strengths and development, because it's not the same having a full-term and a preterm baby, development of therapeutic alliances with the mother, the creation of a same holding environment of the mother, especially mothers of preterm infants, had been shown to be very encouraging. The environmental impact of the NICU and the premature infant's outcome. It is awareness, acknowledgement of the consequences these differences between uterine environment and NICU environment stimuli have on a neurodevelopmental outcome of premature born infants, encourage efforts to humanize the NICU environment, to change the environmental influences, and experiences a premature born infant is exposed to the neonatal intensive care unit, because it's also, we can say, a simulation of the, it should be a simulation of the womb environment. With an attempt to decrease the discrepancy between the immature brain's expectation and the actual experiences in a typical NICU environment, modern neonatal care tends, therefore, to imitate the optimal natural environmental influences and experiences a fetus is exposed to in the mother's uterus as much as possible. First of all, the mentioned adverse environmental stimuli and experiences, the mentioned non-physiological, optical, acoustic, olfactory, tactile, and vestibular stimuli, resulting from the neonatal intensive care unit techniques and the personnel are eliminated or sometimes minimized. Because lack of stimulation and deprivation from physiological stimuli and experiences in hospital environment is the third very important area of refinement process in the NICU setting. Therefore, physiological stimuli that promotes developmental are offered, such as maternal voice, parental touch, or skin-to-skin contact. For this reason, an early intervention in the form of family-centered and developmental promoting care according to the Newborn Individualized Developmental Care and Assessment Program is the well-known NIDCAP as the most advanced family-centered intervention for premature-born infants in neonatal intensive care unit nowadays. The premature-born infants care, according to NIDCAP, has beneficial effects both on the development and the behavior of the child, as well as the mother-child interaction at 3 years later we go on. The impact of supportive care, according to NIDCAP, was assessed through developmental, Griffith's developmental scale, and behavior symptom interview, and tools for assessing mother-infant interaction, parent-child interaction, care of very low birth weight. To NIDCAP have certain positive long-term effects on child hearing, speech, development, behavior, and mother-child interaction. However, we have evidence that the architecture has provided research on the benefits of different options concerning the physical structure of a neonatal unit. There's a tend towards single family room designed when building new units. This provides the family with an opportunity to be with the child in the neonatal intensive care day and night, providing facilities for parents' basic needs, including the need of privacy. As the design has been shown to reduce the length of stay in hospital significantly, for example, 10 days in preterm infants below 30 weeks of gestational ages in Swedish study, it shortens the time of separation for the infant from the home and the family. Parents have reported that they felt that a single family room designed in NICU facilitated their presence beside their infant. However, there are ways, even in traditional open day units, to increase parents' facilities to be close to the infant. Because if we have privacy and a separate place, it's more to express and give and facilitate the parental interaction with a newborn baby, which is so much in need. The island complex of Greece and the accessibility of perinatal health care centers is a basis, is an indicator to improving the model of accessibility in perinatal centers. So in antenatal, we use antenatal transfer, postnatal transfer, or inter-hospital transfers. In utero transfers is not always possible, for example, if labor is too advanced. Of the several models of transporting newborn infants, the most sophisticated are regional transport services that carry out all neonatal moves in defined are using dedicated staff and equipment. Different type of vehicles also can be used to transport neonates. The mode of transport that is most appropriate will depend on rescue availability, geography, clinical pathology, urgency of the situation, and the experience of the staff. More organizations need for an air transfer than for raw transfer. Anticipating the need for transfer, early appropriate preparation for transfer, and ongoing high-quality care during transfer are the core stores for good neonatal transport. To achieve this, the staff need to be trained appropriately. All equipment and vehicles must be fit into purpose, and linear communication must be well established. I will give you some pictures is indicative of the area that the hospital we have worked together covers an immense area, the area of Western Attica, which has six general hospitals, the intensive care units and then the high dependence units. This is the area of Piraeus. This is the island complex of Cyclades, which have labors taken place there. Yet we have not any perinatal care equipped. The island complex of Dodecanese, that of the North Aegean, The reason is specific. The number of Greek islands is enormous, and the distance of the for to reach somebody the administrative centers is long. Although being general hospitals, the local hospitals mentioned above can actually stand as demanding perinatal care centers, but offer only basic health care. Hence, newborn infants or pregnant mothers have to move between hospitals for appropriate care. Similarly, we have the model of the Scottish model, and especially this of Aberdeen. And this is an example of transfer for neonat. There is an increasing evidence show that supporting the benefits of early parent-infant closeness during hospital care of preterm infants, both physical and emotional parent-infant closeness, should be facilitated in neonatal unit taking into account the socioeconomic, political, and cultural variation in different countries. To better understand this issue, we need to explore what facilitates and inhibits closeness and consider implementing strategies that enable closeness. For this reason, the Center for Supporting Motherhood has established several interventions in order to optimize scientific benefits. Thank you very much. Would you like to express any further questions? Or sing? Yes, sir.
I just wonder whether, I come from Australia, and like other developed countries, they have...
From Australia?
Yes.
Yes.
We have mother and baby units there, which are not just, I mean, for the very point you mentioned about the attachment between the mother and the newborn, and of course mothers of preterm babies will have even that many more difficulties in forming that bond. So do you have any such facilities, specialized facilities of having mother and baby units where psychiatrically unwell mothers, either from before or after the delivery of their preterm babies or normal babies otherwise, have found it difficult to bond with their babies and will need specialized psychiatric and psychological care? Do you have any such units, mother and baby units?
No, there are no kind of these kind of facilities. That would be the goal, that would be the ideal for Hellenic statute, but right now all kind of neonatal units, even the special units like cardiac units or the neonatal units, even for the term or the preterm baby, there are no separated self baby mother. There is there is the unit according to level care of unit mode, level 1, 2, or 3. And there are some units in Athens that have, in order to promote the attachment, the bond, allow mothers as long as they want to stay in units and to have some extra care from psychologists or social workers or the medical team, ask questions, watch the procedures. And of course there is another mode that allows mothers some visits, and when the baby is in critical care, the visits are limited, are about 2 hours in a day, or in demand if we feel that the mother should stay because she's in a very difficult situation, or the infant, we can prolong this. After the critical point, and when the baby is not sedated and is not paralyzed, we promote more hours of staying, but unfortunately there are no such kind of cells, even though we, all the medical practitioners, feel that would be the ideal. But this means medicals, nurses that are for one infant and only, and that is in this time of year, in this time of crisis, a very luxury. So we should pay a visit in Australia. That would be very, very, very educative for us.
Well,
Welcome. Thank you.
Mrs. Kedjeva, would you like to add something? Maybe from your experience, because also you have an experience from other countries or other cultures.
Yes, unfortunately, in our hospital and in Greece, all NICU are closed. Parents visit their babies in some hours, only when they are stable. And when the baby is ready to eat, can come to feed the babies. I work in one hospital that more of the preterms are born out. It's the worst. It's worse because they come from islands, from our cities. It's more difficult and. Not only difficult, but it's very expensive for the family. For this, it's very difficult to work with babies and with families. And in this case report that I show you, I remember that I don't know why this baby was have so good result. Yes, because she born in very critical condition. She was born out of hospital. She transported without incubator. I remember that mother was thinking very positive. All the time she was sure that the baby will go very fine. Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, especially, yes, this case, we assume that the good results...
Good result is
yes,
for is good families, yes,
yes,
many times.
It's due to the good family and...
Good family cares, not
yes.
Good family, good, good relationship.
And the positive thinking of the mother, because the issue is to think that the preterm baby, although that does not coincide with the imaginary baby, we had also a discussion before, it's your baby and you have to adapt and not asking this baby to adapt to your family cycle, but you have to be adapted to the newborn, to the preterm. It's vice versa.
Yes, and this is the overpower of mother.
Yes.
A mother and a family dream of a perfect, healthy baby, and then a preterm baby comes. A preterm has several problems, several times malformations, needs a prolonged stay. So she has to love the new baby, the baby that is real and is in jeopardy. And this mother believed her baby from the day, from
yes.
Hour zero. So mother and baby say, helps to believe mother to believe her baby. That very helpful. So here we initiate and we promote mothers to do their way.
The case study that Mrs. Gadjeva handling in the NICU is really representative since it gathers all the hot points. Of the problem of perinatal care, the premature birth, the low weight, the distance, the non-existence.
Active transportation.
Yes. Yes, of course.
So you have a list of recommendations for the politician?
Yes,
several. Full of points.
In Australia you have also a similar model. Which is found in Scottish Islands, in Vancouver, in British Columbia, because they have in Finland also, because they have the island complexes, which need, which strive for an extra force in to reinforce actually the perinatal care. And also in Australia, you have a multicultural also population.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yes.
Which also is similar to us because we try now, we are, tend to be a multicultural society also. And in Australia, it is very stressed, the maternal anxiety towards the perinatal, while entering a perinatal center. Mm-hmm. Because they cannot understand, they don't speak the language sometimes, they feel as strangers.
Yes, of course.
Would you like to ask something else?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.